Hey there! On year 2000, on April I think, I started painting miniatures with the Citadel Starter Kit. This one, it was a great kit with 5 marines, but I painted Dark Angels, not these crappy ultramarines. But around me, everybody was playing Warhammer Fantasy, so I bought a Bretonian box and bought more miniatures, and then I found this Bertrand. This miniature was so cool, was one of my favorite, so that's why I have this miniature until today. So now I'm like 20 years in wargaming, in the hobby, and I say, what if I celebrate this time, this moment, doing what I like? That it is painting, but doing something special. So follow me, I will show you how I repaint this miniature. This miniature was sold by GW at 1996, and I bought on 2001. It wasn't so old on that time, and I remember that it was a cool miniature. Before painting, I'm always cleaning my miniature with this soft brush to remove the dust and whatever it may have. Well, I start painting with matte black some parts of the miniature because I remove some sprue parts or something like that, and mold lines and whatever, so it has to be bezel. Then I choose this dark green, Caliban green, to paint the main cloth, and then I will highlight through the white. But the poncho, or whatever it's the name of this cloth, it will be like a green to green lime. I started with Caliban green and bone, adding more bone and more bone between every coat of paint, but always with a lot of water in the mix, trying to have a time coat. And you will see that I'm painting always on top of the last coat, but leaving some trail of the last coat to leave an appreciation of the transition between green color that we are going to get on the last highlight with more bone. As you may notice, the hat is with the same color, so I create a combination between both clothes. Here I'm painting just like small dots, small lines. And on that time, I only have access to White Dwarf and catalogs, so it wasn't so easy to paint or to have in reference on internet like today, on YouTube or Instagram or Pinterest. So it was pretty hard on that time, improving your techniques and knowing more ways to paint. Now I'm creating a mix with this Army Painter green and yellow, and strong yellow. I'm waiting to this mix dry and start with the pants with a dark brown. I and then highlight with the dark brown plus this bone from skin color. I don't want the pants to be super shining, just adding lights, but no so much light. Then I choose a graphene gray to paint the boots, the inside part of the boots with different tones, so the inside part will be more lighter than the outside part of the boots. As you can see, I am having like one mix for the inside boot that is more lighter, and the outside boot will be a mix more darker. Okay, here we go with the poncho. Adding more and more yellow, I will make more and more coats of highlights. Here I go with the highlights on the outside of the boots. And then I chosen to paint the quiver, I think is the name. The quiver with the same color, just to create a combination between boots and the quiver that you may think were made of the same material, like the same leather or whatever. So that's the idea, to play with the mind of the person that is looking at our miniature. But I will choose a different color for the belt and the handbag. Okay, here we go with the base coat of the shirt. I'm mixing white with blue, but not so much blue to create a light blue, and then I will add more and more white to highlight this white. Then I paint the inside shirt, I don't know if it has a name, with this leather brown, and then I highlight it with one. Here we go with the most important part of the miniature, that is the flesh. I start with a dark brown, then mixing with this base flesh from Vallejo, and then adding more coats and more coats. As you can see, it's a pretty hard work. And then adding natural flesh. And then I added this medium flesh, it's like an elf flesh, just small portions, and then more and more portions of this color. and the last code will be this mix plus bone. And check how the last codes will be only small dots and lines and just a little bit of on every part that it has to be highlighted. As you can appreciate, no washes, no dry brush, just thinning my paints and doing many coats. I painted the hair and the mustache with a mix of with matte black and graphene gray, and then highlight with a mix of graphene gray and moshe white, but no too much moshe white because I don't want to have a super old man. Then the bone will be a mix 50-50 with leather brown and moshe white, and then I draw lines imitating the wood shapes on the bone. Then last coats of the white, adding more and more white but never ending with full white. You never go full white. And then, as I said before, the belt and the handbag with shadow gray, and then mixing with shadow gray and bone, I will highlight a little bit. As you can see, I chosen violet for the feather. The idea here is that create a contrast between violet and green, and highlighted mixing with white. For the arrows, I choose a mix with moshe white and a little bit of shadow gray, and then finish it with only moshe white. And the feathers will be, of course, the same violet highlighted with white. Okay, the hardest part of the miniature and the metallic, non-metallic. This is just painting with white, with a little bit of black, and I use the graphene gray, and mixing and just using a lot of water and thinning and doing it wrong and redoing it. It's just working many times on the same thing until it is done. I painted the bone handle with dark red outside the camera, and then highlighted with two coats of mix of this dark red and flesh. I painted the eyes of this miniature outside the camera because I have a problem with the left eye. It had too much paint from before paint job, so it was too difficult to paint it with the camera. And I also painted the metallic parts of the bone with non-metallic metal. At the end, I draw a white line in the middle and drawing white lines around the shape of the sword. The golden part was with the leather brown and moshe white, and then to have a shiny effect, I add some yellow or vallejo. And then the last coat of highlights with white. Then I remember that it has a bracelet, so I painted with more silver, non-metallic metal. More highlights here and there. The laces of the boots with moshe white and a little bit of leather brown, and then a second coat of only moshe white. And of course I add sand to the base, painted with brown, and then a quick dry brush, and then adding grass for pasture. As you can appreciate, I think it was a great idea to repaint this miniature. Comparing with myself, I think I made a great job here, and I think it really looks great. I hope this new repaint on this model show how much I learned and developed as a painter, especially comparing with myself as a teenager with 14 years old. So I think the best person to compare to you is yourself. Just don't look how much better or not are the other painters. Just look at yourself on past and compare with your today. Okay, this is the end of the video. Please let me know what do you think of the result of my paint job, and also let me know if you want to see me painting the friends, these two friends, Guy Le Gros and Hugo Le Petit, the two friends of Bertrand. Also, if you enjoyed this video, please subscribe and give me a like and put a comment there, so every support that you can give me, it will be really, really welcome. See you in the next one.